Here is our next question. If square root 5 and negative square root 5 are two zeros of the polynomial x cube plus 3x square minus 5x minus 15 and find its third zero, then find its third zero. Since it is a third degree polynomial, it will have three zeros. Here we have already given two zeros, we need to find third zero. So let the given quadratic polynomial will be, let us say, p of x is equals to x cube plus 3x square minus 5x minus 15. We know that if a is a zero of a polynomial, if a is a zero of a polynomial, then x minus a will be a factor of that polynomial. So by using this condition, here square root 5 is one factor, then x minus square root 5 will be a factor. Here minus square root 5 is another factor, then x plus square root 5, and there is a third factor. Let us say the third factor is a. This into this into this becomes the polynomial p of x, that is x cube plus 3x square minus 5x minus 15. So further we can rewrite this by taking x square common from both of these terms, and here you left with x plus here you left with 3, and again from these two terms you can take minus 5 common, and here you left with x and here you left with minus 3 into minus 5 into 3, that is minus 15, so here you left with 3. Further, in both of these terms, x plus 3 is common, and here you left with x square, and here you left with 5. Therefore, x minus square root 5 into x plus square root 5 into a is equals to x plus 3 into x square minus 5. And it looks like x minus square root 5 into x plus square root 5. And this looks like a minus b into a plus b. By known identity, a minus b into a plus b, this becomes a square minus b square. So by using that, and this becomes x square minus square root 5 whole square, this becomes 5 into a is equals to, here we have x plus 3 into x square minus 5. So here both the sides you can divide it, x square minus 5, x square minus 5 ones are x square minus 5 one times. Now here you left with a is equals to x plus 3. Here a is equals to x plus 3. Therefore third factor is equals to x plus 3. Then third zero is equals to x plus 3 is equals to 0. Third zero will be, that implies x is equals to minus 3, which means the third zero of this given polynomial is minus 3. Okay.